The molting process begins when cuticular epidermal cells are stimulated by exposure to 20-hydroxyectisone, the insect molting hormone. The hormone enters the epidermal cells where it stimulates genes related to molting and the formation of new cuticle. The activated epidermal cells undergo mitosis or grow by cellular enlargement. This is the period of growth to form a new, larger cuticle for the next instar. The existing structural cuticle separates from the epidermal cells. This is termed apolysis. The resulting ecdysial space between the endocuticle and the epidermal cells is filled with a gel that contains inactive chitinase and protease enzymes. A new outer epicuticle layer of cuticulin is secreted. This new cuticulin layer protects the epidermal cells and newly forming cuticle from digestion by the enzymes in the molting gel, which is then activated and becomes a fluid. The chitinase and protease enzymes of the molting fluid begin to digest the old endocuticle. As much as 90% of the chitin and protein breakdown products from the old endocuticle are reused by the epidermal cells to form a new procuticle. Digestion of the endocuticle continues until it reaches the old exocuticle. The old exocuticle layer is resistant to enzyme action since it is sclerotized. The remaining molting fluid is reabsorbed. The wax layer and the polyphenol layer of the new cuticle are deposited by the epidermal cells. Just before the molt, the cement layer is released by the dermal glands. Note that the section of old cuticle is smaller than the present region from which it came. This is the result of the epidermal cell growth in the region from which the old cuticle was derived. Molting, which is properly called ecdysis, occurs when the old exocuticle and epicuticle are sloughed off. The shed cuticle is called the exuvium. A hormone called bursicon is released that stimulates the new procuticle layer that was present at the time of the molt to undertake sclerotization by polyphenols and be converted to the new exocuticle. Once sclerotization is completed, no further sclerotization occurs during the remainder of the instar. During the time between the molts, new endocuticle is deposited continuously, and the cycle starts over at the next molt.